next guest took over the airwaves in the mid-60s. Am I on? I just can't hear me. In the mid-60s, little did we know that we were experiencing the dawn of a video age. Actually, when I first saw them, I wasn't sure what I was experiencing, but I knew I liked it. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the phenomenal Monkees.
Oh, I could hide neath the wings on the purple agency. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. The shaving razor's cold, ooh, it stinks. Of me as a white knight on his steed. Well, now you know how happy we can be. And our good times start and end without dollar one to spend. But how much, baby, do we really need?
To this song. You do? Well, come on then. Everybody sing along.
Cheer up, Sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to us? A daydream believer and a homecoming queen. Cheer up, Sleepy Jean. A daydream believer and a homecoming queen.
That was pretty good.
Yeah. Oh, we're so cool. What a privilege to have you guys with me. We're old pals, kind of. We knew each other a long time ago. Keep bumping into each other
down through the years.
Yeah. We sure did. Why is it I always start talking like this when I come to Nashville?
Same reason I talk like this when I go to France.
I'm always talking the same way as you, Mickey, all the time.
And let me ask you something. Did Neil Diamond write that song just then?
No, John Stewart.
John Stewart.
Ah, Daydream Believer. Neil Diamond wrote something.
I'm a believer.
Yep.
Yeah,
and Murray had a hit with that too a couple of years ago.
Yeah, I think it's a good song.
Yeah,
you guys had some good music and stuff. Who started this whole thing? Was it Bob Rafelson
and Bert Schneider?
Yeah, the producers of the show. They had an idea to copy. I think it was A Hard Day's Night, the Beatles movie.
We were going to be
a soft evening's labor, but we decided we wouldn't do that.
You guys had a phenomenal success with NBC. In fact, you ran longer than I did.
Uh-huh. Well, do you remember the day we saw
more
you,
of us, Roger.
We saw you down at Burbank Studio when you were filming your TV show. I've got a great picture on my wall at home in England of the four of us with you outside your limo. You know, you're standing there.
I want you to send me that.
Lemon. That was a lemon.
It's a lemon. It was actually one of those Cal Worthington lemons, I think. Golly, you guys, you're on a national tour now.
Yeah, we sure are.
And Mickey, I know, has been directing commercials and films and stuff in England.
Yes, in jolly old England.
Jolly old England. You speak the language. It helps you a lot.
England goes like a pendulum.
Why, God, I'd forgotten I wrote that. That was great. Bobby's on bicycle. Peter, what are you doing lately besides Monkees?
All I want to do is rock and roll, and that's about what I'm about.
But it shows, I tell you. Davey, you've been all right?
Yeah,
Peter,
I'm
Bon Jovi.
Okay. I've been doing a bit of theater, and I'll be in Florida this Christmas in a show called Oliver. I started in Oliver 20-odd years ago on Broadway.
I remember that.
I played
that's
the
odd 20 years, yeah. Odd 20 years
but,
ago.
But this time when I go back, I'm going to be playing the part of Fagin.
What?
Fagin.
Oh.
Yes.
We don't say that on TV.
Right.
Yeah.
We don't have that kind in Nashville.
A wispy Fagin. Oh, man. How did the Beatles like you? Did they ever say anything, Paul or any of them say anything?
Yeah, they were very kind to us. You know, there was a lot of hoofraw about the Monkees and whether we could do anything and whether we were real, as if, you know, I mean...
John Lennon actually was the first one to compare us to the Marx Brothers, which I thought was very accurate, actually.
I liked it. I think it's accurate. It is accurate.
Much more than it was the Beatles.
Because the stuff y'all were doing is very experimental in television.
And it was about video and a half-hour show every week. We found that the guys who really were on top of their craft, Jimi Hendrix and Janis Joplin, the Beatles, never had an unkind word to say about us.
Yeah. Well, why would they?
Well,
no reason at all.
We paid them a lot of money.
It was the time for them to throw a few sentences together.
Man, there's more questions. Your first hit was about Clarksville, which isn't too far from here.
Yeah, great song that. You know, I mean, that was typical what I thought, what we call bubblegum music.
Yeah.
And the Monkees were pretty bubblegum in the mid-60s compared with all the people Peter was just talking about. But we just wanted to have fun. We were 20 years old. And,
Roger, there's one thing I'd like to say. While the theme song says that we're too busy singing to put anybody down, we found that times have changed. We're not so busy anymore, and we're willing to put a lot of people down. And
in fact, we have a list.
Mile long. We're doing progressive bubblegum now.
You know, Mickey was a star before the Monkees, a child star, as they say, circus boy.
Yeah. It's great, it's terrific, it's the best show on earth. The circus will be in town today.
He's going to do a new show. It's going to be called Circus Man.
Circus Man.
Circus Man.
Yeah. You know, I know you guys will be successful all your lives because you're great guys and you're talented guys. I just the thrill that you came by.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
I don't think we could pay you enough to say
it paid a lot of money. Are you guys up at the front of your tour, or is it in the middle of it, or you got
we're,
more?
We're winding down. We're
winding
in the last.
Down.
We go to the beginning of September, then we're all off to do our own things and see what happens in that department.
You got buses and stuff.
We got buses, real buses
and trucks.
I think they're
buses and trucks.
Out of Nashville.
The buses out of Nashville.
Probably Florida coach.
The buses are fantastic for those people that don't know about the rock and roll buses or the country buses. They've got everything on them.
People are getting in the business today just to get on the buses.
Yeah.
I did. I know I wanted to.
Yeah, a record deal is nothing anymore. You got to have a bus deal. You got to have all that.
It all comes with the deal, does it?
Yeah, it does. Nashville Now, just for a second, if you will. They've been trying to get my attention for a while. Nashville Now is brought to you by Goodies. Hey, I thought Goodies was a gumdrop. I'm sorry. By Goodies provides fast pain relief with the most effective combination of ingredients you can buy without a prescription. That's a lie. Well, anyway, I just say it.
Sweet voice say, D.W. Washburn, this is your lucky day. A hot bowl of soup is waiting, a hot bowl of soup and a shake. D.W. Washburn, we picked you to say, can't you hear the bugle horn? Can't you hear the bell? Even you can be reborn, you're not too mad to well. But if you don't get out of that gutter before the next big rain, D.W. Washburn, you're gonna wash right down
on, get up. Get up off that street.
I'm talking to you, man.
If you can only make
this is the good part.
From your hands to your knees, I know you can make it to your feet.
D.W. Washburn.
I said to myself,
D.W. Washburn,
why don't you go save somebody else? Well, I got no job to go to. I don't work and I don't get paid. I got a bottle of wine. I'm feeling fine. And I believe
Miller and all of our guests will return with more live right after this. Pass the word. You're watching PNN.
Yeah, this night would not be complete without another song from the Monkees. So here they are with What Am I Doing Hanging Round?
Hey, Mickey, why don't you do one of the songs that Michael used to sing?
Yeah, what a good idea. Michael Jackson. I'm mad!
No, not Michael Jackson. Michael.
Oh,
Michael.
Stupid. George Michael. I've got the head thing.
No, Michael.
Michael Jordan.
Mickey.
Oh, no.
Michael Jordan didn't even play music.
Peter, would you get on with Michael Nesmith?
Oh,
Michael Nesmith.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. One, two, a one, two.
Just a lime out Yankee, I went down to Mexico. I didn't have much time to spend, about a week or so. Then I lightly took advantage of a girl who loved me so. And I found myself a thinking when the time had come to go. Took me to the garden just for a little walk. I did not know much Spanish and there was no time to talk. Then she told me that she loved me not with words but with a kiss. And like a fool I kept on thinking of a train I could not miss. I should be on that train and gone. I should be riding on that train, San Antonio. What am I doing hanging around? Well, it's been a year or so, and I'm gonna go back again. And if I get the money, well, I'll ride the same old train. But I guess your chances come but once, and boy, I sure missed mine. But still I can't help thinking when I hear that whistle cry. What am I doing hanging round? I should be on that train and gone. I should be riding on that train San Antonio. What am I doing hanging round? What
I should be on that train and gone. I should be riding on that train to San Antone. What am I doing hanging round? What am I doing hanging round? I should be on that train and gone. I should be riding on that train to San Antone. What am I doing hanging round? I should be riding on that train to San Antone.